Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Boy, great question today sent in by Glenn. Glenn has three components, A, B, and C, and then a total over here. And he wants to create charts from these, and the chart is working great on the component items A, B, or C. So you get a nice little chart here, shows the year-to-date revenue. Life is good, right? But then, when he tries to create the same chart from the total, it has this the drop to zero. So we create the chart. All of a sudden, for the future months, bam, we're to zero. It's like the company went out of business. Well, it's not that the company went out of business. It's just that we don't have any future data. But you know, take a look at how good it looks here and how bad it looks here. Glenn says, oh, I have a lot of charts. I don't want to update these every month. I don't want to go in and edit the series formula or, you know, do anything like that. And he admitted right up front, he says, well, look, I'm using this formula over here in the total to make sure that we don't see anything if it's not filled in. So if the sum of these three cells is zero, then put quote, quote, in other words, nothing. And then otherwise put the sum. Well, that was really close. What you have to do is, instead of the quote, quote, is to put the NA function. NA will force the NA error to show up. The great thing, usually we hate NAs, but the great thing about NAs is that they cause our chart to not plot any data. The chart won't show any data for NA. So, makes the chart look good. Now, unfortunately, it makes the spreadsheet look really bad. We've introduced a new problem. If you're going to print this, go to page layout, click the dialog launcher, and back on the sheet tab, say cell errors as, usually it's as displayed, but I change it to blank to make sure that those cell errors don't print. They still show up in the spreadsheet though. If that's driving you crazy, let's do this. Let's choose these cells, and we're going to go into conditional formatting. So home, conditional formatting, new rule, and we're going to use a formula to determine which cells to format. The formula has to refer to the active cell in this case being K2, so equal is NA K2. If that's true, and it will be replicated throughout, then I want to use a white font. So let's do that. Click OK, click OK, and you see that now the future numbers are not appearing as NA. They won't print as NA because we've changed the page setup, and also the total is working. Now let's just test to make sure that's working. 1800. You see that the chart updates there for the new value. So it seems like it shouldn't be that hard, but there you have it. Once you get it set up with those NAs and get those NAs hidden, and then Glenn, you'll be able to go through and update this every month just by plugging in a new number. Your new charts will update. There you have it. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.